Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Easy no, you don't need figure down. Easy no, no need figure down. Rock that, run that, this how we from. Easy no, you don't need figure down. Easy no, no need figure down. Rock that, run that, this how we from.
It's Where Are You Wednesday, March 13th, 2024. I'm Colin Twigg.
And I'm Carson Merrill with the morning announcements.
Faculty Follies 2024 is almost here. Come watch the PAC staff act a fool on March 22nd. Tickets will go on sale beginning March 18th and are $4. Be part of the PAC tradition.
Girls Places a Women's History Month next Tuesday, March 19th, by sponsoring a Dress Your Best Day. That's right, everyone is encouraged to dress up for school next Tuesday. Celebrate the important woman in your life by putting on your Sunday best, and don't forget to accessorize.
Speaking of Women's History Month, it's time for honoree of the day.
Sarah Winnemucca was a granddaughter and daughter of the Paiute Indian chief from Nevada. She lobbied Congress, wrote extensively, and traveled across the country during the late 1800s, lecturing on the hardships brought upon by Native Americans by the U.S. government. Later named a chief in her own right, her autobiography, Life Among the Paiutes, Their Wrongs and Claims, was one of her first books by a Native American.
Time to run down the lunch menu. Today's main entree features honey barbecue beef sandwiches, seasoned potato wedges, fruits, and milk.
That's a wrap for us.
Go and get it done today, Panthers. If I get too close.
I'm here with Mr. Bott, our new head lacrosse coach, and we're going to get to know him. So, Mr. Bott, how long did you do lacrosse for?
I started playing lacrosse freshman year of high school.
What got you into lacrosse?
All of my friends were doing something in the spring, and I didn't really have a sport, so I decided I was going to hang out with them.
Why did you decide to become a lacrosse coach?
So when I played here 2012 through 2015, our head coach was less than ideal. And I always felt passionately that as long as this school had a coach that cared, the lacrosse program could be so much better than it has been historically.
Is this your first time coaching, or have you done it in any way before?
I was an assistant here 2 years ago, and when I was in college in West Virginia, I ran the youth lacrosse program in Parkersburg, West Virginia.
And how do you think the season's going to go, or what do you hope for?
I think that this is going to be one of the most productive seasons that the program has had in probably the last 4 or 5 years.
All right. Thank you so much, Mr. Bott.
Thank you.